news from Verona? How now, about, sir? Dost thou bring me letters from the friar? How doth my lady? Is my father well? How fares my Juliet, that I ask again? For nothing can be ill if she be well.
Then she is well, and nothing can be ill. Her body sleeps in Capel's monument, and her immortal part with angels lives. I saw her lay low in her kindred's vault, and presently took post to tell it to you. Oh, pardon me for bringing these ill news.
Is it even so? And I defy you, stars. Thou knowest my lodging. Give me ink and paper, and hire post horses. I'll hence tonight.
I do beseech you, sir. Have patience. Your looks are pale and wild, and do import some misadventure.
Tush, thou art deceived. Leave me, do the thing I bid thee to do. Hast thou no letters to me from the friar?
No, my good lord.
No matter. Get thee gone and hire those horses. I'll be with thee straight. Well, Juliet, I will lay with thee tonight. Let's see for means, O mischief, thou art swift. To enter the thoughts of a desperate man, I do remember an apothecary, and hereabouts he dwells, which late I noted in tattered weaves with overwhelming brows. Culling of simples merged with his looks, sharp misery had worn him to the bone. And in his needy shop a tortoise hung, an alligator stuffed, and other skins of ill-shaped fishes. And about his shelves a beggarly account of empty boxes, greener than pots, bladders, and musty seeds, remnants of pack thread and old cakes of roses. They were thinly scattered to make up a show, nothing to this penury, to myself I said. And if a man did need poison now, whose sale is the present death in Mantua and lives in a catif wretch would sell it to him? Oh, this same thought did not forerun my need, and this same needy man must sell it to me. As I remember, this should be the house, but being holiday, the beggar shop is shut. What ho, apothecary!
Who calls so loud?
Come hither, man. Here, hold 40 ducats. Let me have a dram of poison, such soon speeding gear as it will disperse itself through all the veins, that the life-weary taker may fall dead, and that the trunk may be discharged of breath, as violently as hasty powder fired doth hurry from the fatal cannon's wound.
Such mortal drugs I have. But Mantua's law is death to any he that utters them.
Art thou so bare and full of wretchedness, thou fearest day? Famine in thy cheeks, need and oppression starveth in thy eyes, contempt and beggary hangs upon thy back. This world is not thy friend, nor the world's law. The world affords no law to make thee rich. Then be not poor, but break it and take this.
My poverty, but not my will, consents.
I pay thy poverty, and not thy will.
Put this in any liquid thing you will, and drink it off. And if you have the strength of 20 men, it will dispatch you straight.
There is thy gold. Worse poison to man's soul. Doing more murders in this loathsome world than these poor compounds that thou mayst not sell. I sell thee poison. Thou hast sold me none. Farewell. Buy thee food, and get thyself in flesh. Come cordial, and not poison. Go with me to Juliet's grave, and there we must use thee.